Chapter 9, Target 5, Almost Eliminated. While in the stealth, Bond and Q tracked Double O Celetti's position. It kept moving from point to point.
Incredible! Double O Celetti's moving from place to place at a rapid pace. We can barely catch up with him.
I need to know where he is next, Q. You have to go find out where he's going.
It appears he's heading for Florida, the coastline.
Excellent. Here, take my phone and call up the boating fishing dock. I have a friend there who might be able to help.
Meanwhile, David had set up base in Florida and arrived back at his base with Alicia. She sat down in the main sitting area and David entered, slamming the door.
You! I should have known you would sympathize with that spy!
I could only imagine what I would have done to you if it were Bond. I would have to break into every hotel in the country, finding the bed you both would be in. Oh, what a thrill that would be. In fact, yeah. Ever since MI6, one could say that I have had a license to thrill. I mean, with all my attempts to eliminate them, I trusted you. I thought you believed in me. I thought you were going to help me destroy MI6, but no, you're throwing me away like a piece of garbage, which now that I think about it, maybe that's what I should do with you! I should have had Ilya kill you and Double O Celetti! Alicia began to sob.
I just thought it wasn't fair. I felt terrible that I was about to trick him into being killed. I thought I would be nice to him just a little. I am always faithful, you know that, to you, David.
David paced around. Does he know where we are? Alicia shook her head.
Well, perhaps I won't get rid of you.
In fact, you stay there. I'll be right back. David ran off and then returned with his hands behind his back. Now you just relax.
Better yet, why don't you get on the floor? Get comfortable.
I'm happy you decided not to switch sides on me like that, because you would have double-crossed me instead of Daniel. However, you also did give me quite a scare, and that doesn't make me happy. You know, I've been thinking recently. One of the greatest villains of all time that went up against Bond was Franz Sanchez. He was ruthless, unforgiving, and quite condescending. And you know what he did when someone gave him a scare or disobeyed him? David started to move his hands. Elisa sobbed even harder and harder and begged for mercy.
Por favor, David.
Shh, just relax. Remember. Anyway, about Sanchez. Let's just say he was able to whip up a solution. David raised his right hand and cracked a whip onto Alicia, again and again, with the sound growing even louder every time the whip slammed onto her body. The sound was so loud that it got the attention of Sylvia. She peeked through the window of the door of the room where the act was taking place. She was in shock. She broke down the door right before David was going to strike one last time.
Yes, Sylvia?
Did she do something wrong?
Oh, yes.
She made nice with the enemy.
Sylvia looked at Alicia, then back at David.
Let me take a swing,
she said, extending her hand, asking for the whip. David's concerned face soon grew into a devilish smile. Meanwhile, at the docks, Double O Celetti pulled up at the same boating and fishing dock that Bond referred to. He got out of the car and approached the lowered part of the deck and peered into one of the boats. He didn't see any movement until he saw a figure approaching in the reflection of the window. He turned sharply and then fired his gun. The figure moved to the left to divert the bullet. The figure then charged Double O Celetti, and Double O Celetti accepted the charge with a solid punch to the figure's face. The figure fought back, and the two were soon in a strong hold. They stopped in mid-movement.
Daniel, it's me, Bond.
James, what are you doing here?
I could ask you the same thing. Don't you know what you have been up to these last couple days?
I think I know what I've been doing, and so get your hands off me.
They released their grip.
Do you know how many people you have killed recently?
Maybe I'm trying to keep up with you.
Answer my question. All right, I've killed 4.
He paused. Here comes 5. A heavy man with white hair and a white mustache came around the corner towards the dock. He walked to the edge of one of the walks and waved to a boat coming in. This person is on David's work list, Bill Tremble. Bond then looked up toward Tremble's position.
I feel I should recognize him, Bond said.
I don't believe it.
a voice said from behind. Double S Leddy flung his hands back along with Bond, and they both threw the figure behind them onto the ground in front of them.
Gentlemen, really, I'm going to have to start creating stuff for my own protection if this is the way you're going to react.
Bond sighed and got back in his position.
Q, what the hell? Do you know what the two of us could have done to you if you hadn't spoken up?
Well, to be honest, it would have been quite difficult to do. Taking that almost knocked the wind out of me. Luckily, I'm fine, thanks for asking.
Q, come here. I think I know this man. Any recollection? Q went over to 00's position, followed by Bond, and they all watched.
Why, that's Bill Treadmill. He used to be in the calculations expert at Q Branch. He was all ready to answer any high-level math question. In fact, he and I had a bit of a feud of whom had better inventions.
He's not, I'm afraid he's working for David now, 00's lady interrupted. The boat was tied down by now, and Treadmill climbed onto the boat. He walked all the way to the storage bay and signaled one of the guards to open up one of the crates. The guards unlocked the lid and lifted it. Inside were clear packages of white dust.
Now, you're sure this is the genetically altered stuff? Every person that takes this is going to get 10 days of super smart and then brain dead. David wants it to work this time.
Absolutely, Mr. Treadmill. The first batch was experimental. This is the first true batch of the drug.
How do we know it works?
The guard led Treadmill over to the workman's cabin in the boat. He opened the door. Inside were two men with their eyes practically popping out.
This is their 10th day, the guard said.
Treadmill got down and started to ask them questions. He asked them science questions, history questions, grammar questions, and especially math questions.
Finally, what is 6 billion times 250 subtracted from 10 to the 70th power?
There was silence from both men until they began to speak.
Negative 1 times 10 to the 70th power,
both said as they both collapsed to the floor, motionless.
All right, get it loaded onto the boat and ship it off. Super smart drug mixed with a little bit of cyanide and a whole lot of good old-fashioned drugs.
Bond, 00's Leddy, and Q watched closely as the drugs, bag by bag, was put onto the tide boat.
I've got to get him and end this drug smuggling. This must be what David has been up to since MI6.
I'm pretty sure that he still wants you out of the picture, Bond said.
Oh, and speaking of pictures, this is actually for you, 00's Leddy.
Q went over to the Aston Martin stealth and took out the laser camera, as well as everything else.
Now, I've already explained it to 007, but knowing that he would probably not pay attention, I hope you do. Then this is the newest model of camera lasers. Pop the flash open and activate by pressing the shutter. Simple enough, however, this is a bit more advanced.
Q picked up another object and showed it to be a tripod. I'm sensing a theme here, Q.
Well, this will fit your camera, however, this is a bit more. Now, notice here that if you can lift the top part where the camera would sit, there is a targeting scope. Close the latch, and when you're finished, then grab the handle here. You then spin the legs until one of them is locked into place. Unclip the latches on the end and squeeze firmly at the handle. This will fire the leg.
That won't do too much damage, will it?
Actually, it will. Invisible to the naked eye. It is a needle covered with poison. Instant death.
I think this will come in quite handy.
Oh, and one more feature.
Q twisted another screw off the tripod, and the entire midsection came out of the handle and the scope intact.
This is a single missile launcher. Use the scope and handle in the very same way.
He locked the missile launcher back into place. Treadmill soon looked off into the distance and noticed the spies.
Hey, you!
The trio then jumped into action. Bond ran off with his Walther, and 00's Leddy grabbed the tripod. Treadmill had his weapons stored in the bait shop stand and on the dock. He ran over it, and the men jumped from behind the desk and grabbed Treadmill's head and knocked him out. The spy soon arrived at the stand, with Q slowly jogging behind them.
Well done, Willy. We needed that.
Not a problem, James.
Mind introducing us? 00's Leddy asked.
This is Willy Finns. He's the bait stand owner here. He supplied things for a good friend of mine, Sharky.
Pleasure, 00's Leddy answered, shaking Willy's hand.
I guess he took the bait, didn't he, James?
Willy joked. All of them laughed as Treadmill began to get up. 00's Leddy shot him, and Treadmill collapsed to the ground. Just then, Willy screamed from behind.
James, guys, look behind you!
A man came out of the blue and was about to strike Double Slitty until he aimed the tripod and fired one of the legs. The leg shot out and jabbed the man in the stomach. The man then collapsed and cringed as he held the leg. There were guards everywhere protecting the drug, but what was he trying to do? Whatever it is, I think he got the picture. Mind introducing us? Double O's Lady asked. This is Billy Finn,